far for so long. Will you show me better? A new kind of love. It's ever the one I want. I'm lifting you higher, higher. There's nothing that I'd rather do. I show you elevation. Our praises. There's no one I love more than you. I never knew a love like this before. The kind of life that I cannot find on my own. I've seen the world, but I have never been so sure that I want your heart. God, I just wanna be where you are. I've seen my wildest of dreams. Don't come close. I've never known better than living like this. I cannot resist you, Lord. I'm lifting you higher, higher. There's nothing that I'd rather do. A sweet elevation, our praises. There's no one I love more than you. I never knew a
that you're joining me this Sunday morning for our virtual kids church. So we're going to continue our series on the best year ever, and we're talking about school year. I'm going to read to you a list of activities that happen in any given school week, and I want you to tell me if they make you happy. I want you to do your thumbs up if they make you happy or if they make you sad. Yeah, thumbs down. Okay, are you ready? Happy? Sad. Okay, here we go. Getting a good grade on your paper. Does that make you feel happy or sad? Okay. Getting bad grades. Uh-oh. I bet I know the answer to that one. Spending time on the playground. Spending time in time out. That's not very good. Spending time in art class. Spending time in history class. I don't know. Some of you guys may really like that. doing a science project. Oh, I see those thumbs up. I see some of you guys put some thumbs down. Not everybody's into science projects, and that's okay. Solving math problems. That can be a tough one too. Yeah, I see those thumbs up as well. Taking a test. Having a spelling bee. That could be kind of fun if you like to learn new things. Getting a pop quiz. Uh-oh. I don't know if any of you guys have already had it. It's just been the first week for most of you guys. Going home at the end of the day. So some of you guys, you had some thumbs up, and some of you guys had some thumbs down. Some had more thumbs up than thumbs down, right? Every day brings good and bad. And some days are more good than bad, and other days are more bad than good. And just like the unpredictable weather outside, I mean, you could go out and it's so hot, and then when you leave school, it's pouring down rain and it's cold. So you never know, just like the weather outside, you never know what your day is gonna be like. It could be good, it could be bad, or it can go from good to worse. But there's one thing that we can do and we can know, is that we can rely on God no matter how our day is going. Whatever kind of day you're having, you can have joy in all things because joy comes from the Lord. Today's big idea says this: have a joyful attitude every day and look for ways to treat others like Jesus. Will you guys say that with me? Have a joyful attitude every day and look for ways to treat others like Jesus. Our passage today is found in Philippians 4, verse 4 through 9. So that's Philippians, the big number 4, and then verse 4 through 9. And it says this: this is a great passage that reminds us to focus on the Lord and to find joy in Him. But it becomes even more amazing when you realize who's written it. You see, the one who wrote it, his name was Paul. And Paul didn't speak these words from a pulpit. Paul didn't speak or write these words in his comfy little house, nor in a pastor's office. Do you know where he wrote these words? He wrote these words in prison. That's right, you heard me right, in prison. Paul was in jail for his faith, for what he believed in. And he already knew that one day he would be put to death for that same faith. Yet, in spite of the circumstances, being that he was in jail, Paul found the words to tell his brothers and sisters in Christ to rejoice. To rejoice! Here he is in jail, but Paul's telling everyone, rejoice in the Lord. You see, joy isn't an emotion like happiness. Joy is knowing that God loves us and that Jesus died for us, and that no matter how bad things get, no one can take God away from us. Bad times will pass. Hard times will pass. So will good times. But God remains in our hearts forever, and His joy can stay with us always.
Everyone, and welcome back to class. I'm so glad you're here. Have you ever wondered what the difference is between happiness and the joy of the Lord? Well, today we are going to look into the Bible and do a little experiment to see if we can figure it out. You know what it means to feel happy, right? You know, when the sun is shining, when everything seems right, when things are going your way, then you feel happy, right? Like this. Joy might look just like happiness on the outside, but today we're gonna do an experiment and see if we can talk about what the differences are. So the first thing we're gonna do is light this candle. This flame is going to represent all the bad and hard things that happen in our lives. And they happen in everybody's life, right? It could be anything, a big bad thing or a little hard thing. So let's light this candle. There it is. And also, since we're doing a science experiment, we have to be safe. So this balloon represents happiness. And when something hard or bad happens, what happens to happiness? Whew! Wow, that was exciting. What happened? That happiness, when something bad or hard happened, just popped, it went away. And that kind of happiness is only there because a person is thinking about the things around them that are good. So when something hard or bad happens, their happiness is gone. So before we do the second half of our experiment, let's look at what the Bible says about joy. We're gonna look up Psalm 16:11 together. It says, "You make known to me the path of life. In your presence, there is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore." Joy isn't just a feeling. It's a deep knowing that God loves you and that He's on your side. It's remembering who He is, no matter what happens in the world around you. And thinking about Him instead of looking at yourself or thinking about the bad and hard things that happen in our lives. Let's continue with our experiment. Again, remember, the flame represents bad and hard things that happen in our life. And also, we want to make sure, since we're doing an experiment, safety first. Happiness and joy may look the same on the outside, but let's see what happens when the person who's filled with the joy of the Lord has something bad or hard happen. The joy doesn't go away. Even when a Christian is sad because something bad or hard happens in their life, we can still be joyful in the Lord because of who Jesus is and what He has done. Thinking about what Jesus did and what He has done for you is how you can live a life filled with joy. Even when bad and hard things happen, you can still have the joy of the Lord.
But seek first His kingdom and His righteousness. All of these things will be given to you as well. Matthew 6:43. Look, Sam has joined us. Hello, Mommy. Let's say amen. We will start together. Seek first His kingdom, His righteousness, and all these things will be given you as well.
Paul gives us a three-step plan for finding joy. First, we need to remember God. Everyone say that with me. Remember God. We need to remember who He is and what He's done for us. We need to rejoice and know that God is still God and to thank Him for His goodness and praise Him for who He is. Secondly, we need to give our worries to God. Say that with me. Give our worries to God. We need to tell Him why we are sad, why we're stressed out, why we're frustrated. Give God all the bad stuff. Tell Him to take it from you and ask Him to give you His joy. And number three, we need to focus on the good things. Thank God for your family. Thank God for our church. Thank God for your great friends. Focus on the good gifts that God has given you. sunshine, rainbows, flowers, puppies, football games, Oreos, you name it. Anything good and pure that makes you happy, think on those things. Remember all the good that God has given you, and you'll find the joy of the Lord just welling up inside of you. When you have the joy in your heart, you can even share it with other people. You see, because people all around us are struggling, especially during this time right now. So the joy that is inside of us can also impact other people. Sharing God's love with someone else can turn their bad day totally around. Tell them what Jesus did for you, and then encourage them to ask God for His joy. God can use you to spread His joy and good news to all those around us. And that's a recipe for making even more joy in your life. It isn't easy to remember to seek joy when bad times come. When the teacher uses the word, pop quiz, we tend to kind of get those chills down our spine. When our friends say something hurtful, the last thing on our mind is rejoicing in the Lord. But these are the very things that Paul says we need to give to God. Give Him the cruel words, the name-calling, the bad days, the stressful days, the overwhelming days. Give them to God and ask God for His joy in return. Having the best year ever isn't just going to happen out of the blue. It happens one day at a time, and it happens with each of us. Making that decision, choosing to rejoice no matter the circumstances. Rejoice in the good days. Rejoice through the bad days. Share your joy with others who need it. Day by day, make this year a year of joy, the best year ever. Let's pray. God, we thank you so much that you are such a good God. And Lord God, even in the midst of all these circumstances that we're faced with, Lord God, the difficult times that we've been faced with over these last several months, I thank you, Lord God, that you are so faithful and you are so good to us. And Lord God, that just as Paul wrote, that we needed to rejoice in you. So Lord God, I pray that all the bad, all the negativity, that those are not the things that we focus on, but that we focus on you instead and what you've done for us, Lord God. Lord, we love you and we thank you. Continue to be with us, protect us, Lord God, and help us to have the best year ever. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. We'll see you guys on Wednesday. Bye, guys.